Tijenia.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome to another reaction video put forward by the two most influential people in the world. Welcome to another reaction video from the Clown and Crown Connection. Welcome to another reaction video from the cap wearing, glasses wearing joke of South London. The one and only, the man of the hour, Zeeshan.
I gave it to you this time.
You did. How's it going? And I have the lion here. And for this cause, bro, we need the lion.
Yes.
We need the roaring of the lion, bro.
I'm going to be doing it.
Yes. Yeah. And you have something for us to react to today.
Absolutely.
And?
Absolutely, yes.
It's authentic. It's real, yeah?
It's not a joke. And they've actually published it themselves. So I'm quite surprised.
Okay, so we're going to check it and we're going to see what the lion, the crown and clown connection. Let's see, because you know what, bro? I think people that are justifying what's going on in Palestine, bro, they I think clown is enough for them.
No doubt about that. Look, I mean,
it's enough for them.
They're one of two things. If they're justifying it, they're one of two things. Either they're ignorant of the situation or they have a racist agenda. Simple as that, really. They don't like Muslims. They have a racist agenda or they have an Islamophobic agenda. I don't see a third party here. I can't imagine why someone would support Israel otherwise, you know. Oh, maybe economic interests.
Yeah,
geopolitical and economic interests, like the United States of America. Absolutely.
That's true.
Absolutely.
All right, let's see this video, yeah?
Yep.
כשאני אומרת לכם ירושלים, מה עובר לכם בראש? מה זה ירושלים? בית המקדש.
כותל. מה עוד?
מי מאמין שבית המקדש ייבנה בשנים הקרובות?
The temple.
מה יש שם עכשיו על בית המקדש?
No.
Basically, what's happening here is that she's trying to plant in their minds there's going to be some kind of destruction of the Aqsa Mosque and replacement to the temple. These are growing up now. They're going to be part of the IDF, as we know. You know.
Yeah, because every child, every
citizen,
has to serve in the Israeli army.
Yeah, there's a few exemptions.
Yeah, but these people don't fall under those exemptions.
Definitely not.
What happened? It will collapse, explode, disappear. Okay, you've met Arabic. Okay, good. Okay. Pushed me away.
ומה קורה כשאתם רואים ילד ערבי? מה אתם מרגישים?
זעם.
Angry.
ומה קורה כשאתם...
He was smiling when he said that. Look at that.
No, but what's mad is that the teachers are not correcting this behavior. It's like this is what they want.
I want to kill them.
I feel I want to kill them, yeah.
מה קורה כשאתם פוגשים ילד חילוני? למה אתה מרחם על אף שלא נולד חרדי? מה הוא מפסיד? כשאתם חושבים על ירושלים בעוד 10 שנים. כולם חרדים?
לא כולם חרדים. חלק ערבים, חלק
חרדים. יש גם
ערבים שהם עובדים. But they will be slaves.
That's what they want, man.
All the Arabs will die and they'll become our slaves. With you, all the information. Keep up the education here.
No wonder why they're coming out. So a lot of them are coming out racist and a lot of them are coming out so intolerant to other cultures.
Now, obviously, not all Jews are the same. Just like not all Muslims are the same, not all Christians are the same. And we're not saying that these people represent all Jews.
And in fact, the Quran says that, just to be clear. I mean, the Quran says, "Laysu sawa'a," that the Jews and Christians are not the same. And the Quran has a very similar message about Muslims. So what you've said there is backed by the Quran, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, "Minhum muqtasid, minhum zalimun nafs, minhum muqtasidun, minhum sabiqun bil khayrat." You know, there's three categories of Muslim. There's the one who's in the middle path, there's one who's very excelling in good deeds, and there's one that's oppressive to himself. So it's not as if the theological texts of Islam don't recognize the nuances, both in Muslim communities and demographic and Jewish and Christian communities and demographic. The message we wouldn't teach our kids that all Jews are the same, or that all Muslims are the same. I think that would be a naive teach, or indeed that we should generalize any community.
Yeah.
And I think this is the problem with this kind of education. It's forcing a generalization, a sweeping generalization, because it creates a neat binary for them so they can have a protagonist and an antagonist, and so that they may basically be discriminatory. It's teaching them to be discriminatory when they grow up towards another population, racially different population.
Who they are going to be responsible over. Yes. Because as soldiers, yes, as police, you are occupiers, so it's your responsibility, yeah?
Yes.
If it's your responsibility, you can't now say, oh, the Palestinians need to do this, or they have this response. No. Mm. You're the occupying power. Mm. You're the one with the military prowess. Mm. You're the ones that have the ethical and moral duty to look after the people.
People don't realize that there's about 25% of so-called Israel are Arab people living there. So you're quite right. Like, you know, people think that all the Palestinians are in either Gaza or the Palestinian territory. No, there are about 25% of the overall population are in Israel. They live in there. They're Israeli citizens for all intents and purposes. Now imagine this. You have people in your own country who you consider citizens just like you, but you, the reason the word Arab, I mean, because of their racial and ethnic difference, that is the reason why they should be discriminated against. And this is something, by the way, the Quran actually condemns. It acknowledges about some Jewish people, not all of them, as we know, but some Jewish people, they use theology to practice a kind of ethnic and theological supremacy, that you think that you're better because of your race. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in two verses of the Quran that I can think of right now, he says, if you think that you are the chosen people, min duni nasi, from aside from the people, fatamannaw al-maut in kuntum sadiqeen, then wish for death if you are indeed truthful. You believe in an afterlife. Maybe it's not specified exactly what kind of afterlife, but what are you doing in this world? You should be asking for death. If you think your ethnicity is your passport to salvation in the afterlife, then what are you doing in this world? And the Quran says, وَلَا يَتَمَنَّوْنَهُ أَبَدًا بِمَا قَدَّمَتْ أَيْدِيهِمْ, and they will never be asking for that.
And to be fair, if you're the chosen ones, number one, why would you want to demolish someone's holy site just to put your own holy site there? Mm. Number two, why would you want to enslave an entire group of individuals? Yeah. Does this show you to be people that harbor qualities of the chosen ones?
Yeah. For them, yeah, the answer is yes. In fact, you can even go further than that. The Old Testament has, I personally believe, contaminations and interpolations itself, which indicate tribal superiority of the Jewish people. I think probably foremost among which is when the Old Testament says that God repented to Israel.
Wow.
Okay, imagine that now. It's humbling, putting God in a humble position to this tribe of Israel. And when it refers to Ismail, refers to him as a wild man. So because obviously he's of a different kind of lineage, he became the father of the Arab. So you can trace a lot of these problems to the Old Testament, quite frankly. A lot of the old problems in the Old Testament, the Hebrew Bible, have these racial and ethnic overtones. Let me tell you one thing, actually, just because it just came to my mind. When people read these stories of the Old Testament and the New Testament, and the Quran, for example, there are similar stories. Yeah, one of the similar stories is we all know the Exodus is when Bani Israel, the children of Israel, went from escaped Egypt and basically through the Red Sea and so on. The Quran, the central message of the Quran is that Moses said to Pharaoh to worship one God, and he also said, "Bring my people with me and let the people go," and so and that kind of thing. You don't even find that in the Bible at all, by the way. From my memory here, I don't think there's any one time Moses said to Pharaoh to worship God. And if it was not definitely not the center point of the discourse. The center point of the discourse was, let my people go. Mm. So it's all about the people, about the Jewish people. They are the chosen ones. They are the ones who are promised a thing. So let my people go. Whereas the Quranic message is universal. You know, Ya Yuhannas, Inna khalaqanakum min dhakarin wa untha wa ja'alnakum شعوبٍ وقبائل تعارف إن أكرمكم عند الله أتقاكم, that we have made you into tribes and nations so that you may get to know one another. You know, and the best of you are the most, you know, pious. And the Prophet said, there's no fadl, there's no virtue of a black man over a white man, or a white man over a black man, or Arab over non-Arab, or non-Arab over an Arab, and that the best of you are those who are best indeed. So it's a universal religion. Quite frankly, you can see this is a kind of madrasa for them. This is the equivalent of madrasa.
Yeah, because we're a lot in the spotlight.
Yes, with the madrasas and stuff like that. But we believe in, we are the, no one can deny that Islam is a multicultural universal religion. Whereas Judaism, quite frankly, is, the reason why it's not proselytizing is because it's exclusivist. Mm. It is an exclusivist religion. And that can sometimes, and we're not saying all Jews interpret the scripture that way, but it, the scripture can be interpreted in ways which are, which give someone racial entitlement or give someone tribal entitlement or ethnic entitlement. And we're seeing that play out in those kind of classes for those innocent children.
And somebody could say this is a one-off clip, but this is one of many clips that have been circulating on social media.
No doubt.
These are of children, but you've seen adults being interviewed on the street, and they're, the sort of stuff that they're saying echoes the sentiment of these little children. Mm. And seen as all of these individuals will have or will serve in the military at one moment in time, and they, and there's clips going around of soldiers ripping women's hijabs off and, you know, throwing grenades whilst using a Palestinian child as a shield, and some stuff that if I show, I mean, the social media will immediately just just take it down. So this is the sort of stuff that's going on, and where it's rooted from, we really need to expose this stuff so, you know, it becomes brought to the surface, yeah, and we can start dealing with it. Otherwise, we're just tugging at the leaves whilst the roots carry on creating more and more leaves.
Zishan, it's been a pleasure. I think it's fantastic analysis. And as always, keep going, comrade. Oh, you and Ali are doing a great.
Bro, you as well, man.
No, I have to keep up.
Now, we all keep each other, motivate each other, and inshallah, you guys will join in whatever capacity you can.
And listen, guys, we have to think about this now. Look, honestly, the Muslim voice is on social media. And just look at the last 10 videos this man has done and the last 10 videos Ali Dawa has done. I am absolutely, it actually relieves me because I've got so much anger watching these things that when we have really millions of people watching now with the content, millions of people, that we're not exaggerating, just in the last 10 days, millions of people have been exposed to this. And bear in mind, the population of Israel is like maybe 10 million or something itself. So we are getting through to as many people as there are almost, you know, in parts of Israel or large chunk of it. So this is really good work, and it should not be underestimated. Please make sure that you guys are sharing and liking and subscribing to their channels, because we need this more than anything else, and we need this now more than any other time.
Jazakallah khair, Muhammad Hijab, and I'll see you inshallah next time.
Inshallah.
Assalamu alaikum.